Hello and welcome back to The Goodness Margin, the place where we find margin for the good things in life. Today, I want to talk to you about something I get a lot of questions about. Anytime people hear about my son doing chores or they see him doing things, they always have questions. How do you get your kids to do these things? How can I make my kids do these things? So today, I want to share with you five simple tips for raising responsible and capable kids. Our kids are so much more capable than we give them credit for. I know that I didn't realize this when I only had one child. I did a lot of things for him, but I've come to the realization, he's 14 now, that really soon he is going to be a grown man. He is going to be living on his own. And there are a lot of things, responsibilities that are going to fall on his shoulders and things that he needs to know how to do. I tell him often, I'm not raising a 14-year-old. I'm raising a man. Does this mean that I treat my five-year-old daughter like she's a grown woman, or even treat my 14-year-old like he's a grown man? Absolutely not. But I do have to realize it is my responsibility to raise him to be an adult, to raise her to one day be an adult. So the first thing is to realize that they are capable. Our kids are so capable. And when we give them those responsibilities and they achieve those things that we teach them to do, they learn to do things, there is a lot of satisfaction that they receive. Of course, if you ask any kid, hey, would you rather go play video games or do you want to do chores? They are going to pick having fun. But the reality is there is a satisfaction that we receive whenever we do a job well. The first thing we have to realize is our kids are capable. They are capable many times of so much more than we give them credit for. Number two is to do it with them. I have tried this many times. I've told my daughter to clean her room up. I've told my son to, hey, can you clean the car out? And sometimes they will, you know, be able to do that to some level. However, whenever I am teaching my daughter how to clean her room, which is what I'm doing right now, she's only five. If I come in the evening and she has had a really great time playing, which is really what I want that space to be there for. I want her to enjoy it. I want her to pull her toys out and to play with stuff. But she's created this giant mess rather than saying, okay, clean your room and knowing that I'm going to come back in 15, even 30 minutes and not a lot of progress will be made. Instead, I can say, hey, let's do this together. We'll set a timer for 5 minutes and let's see how fast we can get this done. And I instruct her, what you need to do is put all of your dress up stuff into this basket. Okay, now what you need to do is take all of your stuffed animals and put them in your stuffed animal basket. I am doing it beside her. It's exciting because we're racing against the timer, but what I'm really doing is I am teaching her how to do it. One of my son's responsibilities is to clean my car out once a week. And even now, after he's done it multiple times, I will take some time every few weeks and say, okay, I'm gonna do this with you. And I'll point out, hey, don't forget, use this vacuum attachment when you're vacuuming out the car seat. Or these things stay in the car, these things come out of the car. I'm just taking simple steps to teach them how to do things. It goes so much better, so much faster if we take the time to work alongside them. They're not going to do it right the first time or maybe even the 100th time, but we are teaching them how to do things. Number three is clear expectations. We all want clear expectations. If our boss asks us to do something and we think they mean one thing and they actually meant something else and we have to redo it, no one enjoys that. And so it's the same thing with our kids. If we ask them to do something, be sure that you give them clear expectations. Actually, developmentally, we may think, oh, I'm micromanaging the situation, but you're not. Developmentally, they want to please you. They want to do the right thing, but how are they going to do that if they have no idea exactly what your expectations are? I realized that this was a problem that I was having when I would ask my son to clean his room and he would think he had accomplished it and truly think, hey, I've done this, but inevitably he would forget a few things. On his chart that he has, his weekly chart, which I will link that in the blog post that is linked below, he has a list of things he has to do each day. And he knows at 14, he has a lot more free time than he used to have. But he knows I can't be doing whatever I want to do unless I've completed these things. And then on the back of it, I have a list of, so if today is the day that he cleans his room, well, he can't forget to vacuum and dust and be sure that his desk is clear. Those little things are outlined as a list. That way he has a list to go by. He knows when things are done, and I have clear expectations. When I ask him if he's completed it, he can say with a surety, yes, that he has, because my expectations have been clear. He knows exactly what he's supposed to do, and he knows that it has been completed. Number four is to let them make mistakes and let there be consequences. If we think about it in life, there are consequences for us not doing things. Now, I'm not saying that the first time you ask them to do it and they do it incorrectly, you say, oh my word, you're grounded for a week. Absolutely not. But with the list that I was talking about that my son has, if I come around the corner and he's playing video games and then I realize that he hasn't done half the things on his list, maybe he forgot one thing and he truly actually forgot it. There is grace for that. And I believe in grace, and I teach my kids, okay, I'm giving you grace. I realize you made a mistake. Let's move on. But if he intentionally left something off that, he's not going to be able to play video games for the rest of the day. That is a consequence of his actions. And I am not a super parent. I have not written a parenting book. I'm constantly reading parenting books, trying to learn. But I consistently have people say, how do you get your kids to do this? My kids just want to play on the iPad, or they just want to do this. Well, the reality is I'm the parent. That's my responsibility. I am the parent. No matter how old my child is, they're under my roof and I am the parent. If they're playing on their iPad, or if they're playing a video game, or even playing with something that is a toy that they can play with when they're completed with their task and they haven't done their task, the iPad is now mine, or the internet is turned off, or you're not playing video games for the next 2 days because you directly disobeyed what you were supposed to do. As the parent, it is also my responsibility to allow them to make mistakes, but also to allow them to learn that there are consequences for their actions. And the last thing that is really important is to let them overhear you praise them. I have been so impressed by the responsibility that my son has taken. He has changed so much and matured so much over the last few years. And he is really so capable. He has learned to do so many things. And I try to, if he is within earshot, to be sure to express to one of my friends, wow, I'm so impressed by the way that Wyatt has been taking initiative with taking the trash out early in the day. Or he is just so smart. He's doing so well in school. I've been really impressed by how hard he's been working. Those kinds of things. With my little girl, she is a little mess maker and she loves to be creative and to rearrange things. And so rather than consistently talk about, oh my goodness, I feel like I'm always cleaning up after her, I try to really praise her and for her to overhear me praising her whenever that she has taken the time to pick up her toys, or rather than make a mess in two different rooms, she picked up one before she started playing in the other one. It's really, really important that our kids hear us praise them, not only to their face, but that they overhear us talk about how great they're doing with other people. And just a little side note, mom, if you're feeling really overwhelmed and you have littles at home, one day they are going to grow up and they're going to be able to help you. We are a family. We talk about that together. My husband and I, we do not pay my son to do his normal chores. He is not paid to pick the dishes up and bring them to the sink, rinse them, and put them in the dishwasher after dinner, because he's a part of our family. We have worked together. We all work together. We all have the responsibility of living here together. And so the great thing is that you start training that 2-, 3-, 4-year-old to help you pick up. One day they're going to be a 14-year-old that's able to unload and reload the dishwasher just as well as you could do it, all without supervision. That day is coming. In the blog post, again, that's linked below, I have a list of ideas for you. If you think, well, what is my child capable of? It's really amazing how capable our children are. If your child is 3 or under, they are capable of taking the diaper. You've changed their diaper, you put it in the bag, they can take that to the trash can. I know that my daughter was barely walking and I would say, okay, this goes to the trash. And she was so proud of herself just taking something to the trash can, or changing, finished with bath time, we put our pajamas on, our clothes are laying here. She's only 1.5 years old. Take this to the hamper. I'm teaching her at a very young age to do those things. They can be very helpful even at that young of an age. And then as they grow, they can start doing all kinds of things. And I have ideas listed for you below in this blog post. My job as a parent is one of the most important things that I will ever do in my lifetime. And I know that our children are so capable of being responsible. I am raising adults, and I hope that my children grow to be responsible adults. I hope that these tips have helped you, have given you some ideas that maybe you realize how capable your children are. I believe these things will give you margin in your life for the good things. If you've enjoyed this video, I would love for you to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified when the next video goes live.